Morning, ladies, gents, and jerks. Been quite a while since I've been on camera, I know. Just haven't had much to talk about. Probably hearing the whirring of my computer fan. I don't know why it's been so loud recently. But the reason I'm on camera is because Roland Warzecha just released a new video regarding Axe and Shield, and I don't really agree with his interpretation, so now's a perfect time to go over it. He, generally speaking, uses a sword, and the way he uses this and his round shield, you can definitely tell he's primarily sword and buckler. So the way he does it, he's way out here with these, using them where they're always touching, pivoting around here, and pushing his shields as against theirs, and sort of pivoting with this thing, which their shields kind of flop loosely all about, and then jabbing here. In his new video, at one point, he puts his shield way up here, and then the other guy gets him in the gut. And I don't agree with how he does it, so I'm going to explain how I do it. This is the combination I've used more than anything else, even spear and shield, and that was my go-to thing for the last chunk of time that I did the fighting stuff. Been a while. But this was my main weapon set, and here's how I tended to use it. So you notice with the center grip shield, it's very pivoty. It's hanging just here by your center grip in your hand, your wrist here, it's all that really controlling it. So it's very, very floppy. Using that floppiness, the pivot, that's what you really got to do. How do you stop it and how do you control it? Easy. On this side, you've got your elbow here. It's not going to pivot past your elbow. So they can keep it all here all day long, and unless your arm gives, you're not going to be opening up. But this side, you can see there's not really anything there. Or is there? So you have this hand. You can use the top of your axe, your hand itself, or admittedly the cross guard, and this is a bit long, your sword here. On a most Dark Age swords, the cross guard top and bottom, these were equal, so it was basically like another handle. You can use that, that's a buckle doesn't rattle around, and you can brace it. Now, it's not going to be pivoting this way because your hand is in the way, or the top of your weapon. I wouldn't recommend the tip of a sharp sword, but you can do it. Top of an axe would be better for using your weapon, or just your hand. So if you're doing this and somebody does the shield push, like what Roland Warzecha shows in his first video on this topic, which that video greatly helped me. So it is good stuff, but that shield push of his, it'll hit here, but since your hand's right here, it doesn't really do much. A lot of people in the group I was in, after seeing that, they tried that all the time, and just doing that's all I had to do to stop him. And with this, it's a big shield. 30 inches, not small. Not my biggest. I got a 36-inch Viking shield behind the camera and a 36-inch Greek shield over there, but it's not a small shield. And in order to block my head and my leg, I don't have to move it all that much. Just, boop, my head's covered. Can't get me on this side because the shield edge is here. Can't get me here because the shield's here. If I need to block my legs, that's really all I gotta do. Just boom and boom. I don't have to move it a bunch. And I tend to stand with my right side forward like this. So just boom, and that's all I had to do to cover myself. Sometimes you might want to do this. Somebody's got an axe coming here. Since axes go around the shield, you kind of need to move a little more, otherwise they might still get you. Like if they're coming up here, just having the shield here, sword would be stopped, but the axe, not so much. So just doing this, cover. And as for the axe itself, the axe is top heavy, but a lot of people seem to think that the axe is heavy, chunky, clumsy, just uncontrollable. Not really. This thing's usually 1-2 pounds at most, even the really long ones. This is my medium length hand axe. I've got one that's longer and one that's shorter. And I really like this one. Nice weight, decent enough reach for me. I like to get in close and do the business. With these, you can't really use them like a sword. Put the shield down. When you're doing like a sword cut, every kind of thing you're doing. You want to stop with your point forward so you can react differently. Particularly if you're doing sword and buckler, because this is as much your defense as the buckler. X, it's not so simple. Because it's got all that mass, it's going to want to... Especially the longer ones. So trying to stop it, not so easy. So one thing that I've learned, if you whiff, whip it around. Basically like a medieval flail. You cut... Molinette, I think it's called when you do this sort of fancy twirly-whirly. So cut, bring it around. With shield, from here I want you cut, bring it around like this. Like that. I can bring it back right there, or bring it around there, come down here, around here. I can use that momentum to wind up the next attack, which is very handy. From here, I can keep the pace up just by keeping things swinging, and it doesn't take hardly any effort once it gets going. And one way to get this to handle these things really well is with the cast blow. Roland Warzecha is the one that first brought that up, if I recall right. And he did swords. Same thing applies to the axes. More so because they're balanced up here. All the mass right behind it, that cast blow is really, really deadly. So, the axe, you can't really treat it like a sword, obviously. You can't do the sword fencing. It's pivot points up here. Whereas on a sword, it's down here. So, you have to treat them differently. And you have to treat a big shield different from a small shield. So, that's basically my take on it. Sum up, the big shield, it's big. You don't have to move it around much. You can brace very easily. Axes, use the cast blow, and bring it around. There's other tricks to use it. Hooking, jabbing, some other stuff like that, but that's the main point. So, yeah, now it's taken off.